Folk tradition and or by others, so taking folk music and make it into concert music, or what we call classical music. Now, in this program, we thought of mixing some folk music and some classical music, and so it's all going to be a little, a big kind of dish with everything inside. And of course, some Bach, because, you know, I can't make a concert without this guy, apparently. Yeah, what can I do?
10th anniversary of Lunel Mandolin Festival, and this is really a symbol for me of how the mandolin world on all its various styles and colors is right now in the world. And what interesting is about this festival is it's all inclusive. You can hear the same instrument, the mandolin, it at least have the same name, although when you see the concert it doesn't feel like it's the same instrument because there are so many different styles and artists that use it in a different manner. For me as a mandolin player, of course, it's interesting because I get to see a lot of other mandolin players using the instrument in different styles, so I'm very curious about it. And I would also go to Hamilton de Hollanda or to Jack Jolien to see like how exactly do you do this and how do you use it and how. So this is fantastic to be part of it. I don't think there's any other mandolin festival in the world that has this variety of styles and of genres. It's also an amazing experience to sit in a concert hall and to, for example, to hear one half of classical Baroque mandolin playing and the other half, again, the same instrument playing choro music or bluegrass. So in a relatively short amount of time, a very concentrated few days of the festival, you hear a lot of different kinds of music, all celebrate our wonderful little instrument. Thank you.